I've been wanting to do an unscripted video for some time now. Just kind of shoot the shit, you know what I mean? So, I was playing Digimon World, and I came across the goddamn Monochromon part. I hate this part so goddamn much. Digimon World is one of my favorite games of all time, and I absolutely love replaying it for 100% prosperity runs. But holy shit, it comes to a grinding halt when I try to get this jackass. This minigame is just like the most unfun thing in all of gaming, I swear. It is so stupid, and there's really no way around it other than RNG manipulation, which I don't know a good way of doing that because I'm playing on the PS3. And most guides out there are really just to do how to do it on the PS2. So let's talk about why I hate this goddamn piece of shit. So basically, the background is this. Monochromon runs a little shop in the middle of nowhere. He runs it in the Grand Canyon, which is behind the Invisible Bridge. So now, he sees the player and he's like, hey, do you want to work for me for 12 hours? So the player gets behind the counter and he just starts selling shit. But oh my god, this shit sucks. This is the problem number one. The items are completely random and I'm pretty sure there are some times the game does not set you up to succeed. I can't tell you how many times I've gotten like a dozen meets in a row. It's absolute bullshit, dude. Like, there are only 16 customers, and I swear, there have been runs where I've gotten at least 8 meats. Right there, because meat, you can't get profit off of meat. The most profit you can get, I believe, is 40, and the goal is 3,075. Yep, not just 3,000. There have been times where I've gotten 3,000, and I jump up for joy and realize, wait, shit, I didn't get enough, did I? It's aggravating. It is aggravating, god damn it. Okay, so there are 4 customers. First one is Gaburimon. Gaburimon is the little green goblin dude, and this guy is a bro. Like, you can basically just charge him out the ass and dick him around, and he'll be like, fine, I'll buy it. Once in a while, I guess this will backfire, but usually, I really would say 8 to 9 times out of 10, just charge the highest you can, and this fuckface will buy it. But then you move on to Weedmon. Weedmon is a douchebag. Weedmon is so stupid, you literally cannot charge him any more price than usual, or he'll run away. Up next, you got Gatsumon. I'd probably put him in second place. He's pretty chill, but he unexpectedly leaves, and like, when you need him not to, like, you need him to have a clutch moment, and he just won't. And then there's Munchamon, which is kind of like more of a wild card, and I just don't really like him either. So really, the only one customer that's like, you can abuse pretty, like, commonly, is Gaburimon. And it makes it very, very difficult when you get a string of Weedmons, because you barely make any profit. If this stupid game worked as intended, then this wouldn't even be an issue. Usually, you know, when you see a smiley face, you think, hey, they're gonna buy the shit. That's not the case. You know what? Blank the faces. Don't even pay attention to the fucking faces. And I can't tell you how many goddamn times Weedmon has a giant ass smile on his face and he leaves. I charge a normal price because I'm like, you know, I can't afford to lose a customer. I'm not gonna lower the price because I need some money off of this bullshit. And guess what? He'll have a happy face and he'll fucking run away. And guess what happens when one of the guys runs away? You lose an additional fucking customer. You only get 16 customers or so like, this is a huge blow. You really can't afford to lose one. Unless you have, like, a really lucky string of medicine, which that's what I'll get into next. There are only 3 items that the customers can buy. Those 3 items are, in order of importance, medicine, porta potty, and meat. Meat is fucking useless. Listen, the most that you can get off of meat, the most profit, is like 40. Out of 3,075, that is nothing. That is literal dick. That is pussy shit. That is not gonna help you whatsoever here. So basically, you need to bank on medicine and porta potties. But meat is the most common. At least, it seems like it. At least on this most recent run of my PS3. Like, just look at the fucking footage here. I get so much meat in a row, it is goddamn insane. The game literally sets it up sometimes that you cannot succeed. Even with medicine, I usually get a goddamn Weedmon. So, I think, if I remember correctly, if you raise the price the most you can get 800 profit off of medicine. But I always get Weedmon. So the most that I really get from medicine is 300. And like, don't get me wrong, 300, that's a tenth of the goal almost. That's super useful. But man, if that was like a Gaburimon that I could just dick around my way to like getting 800 profit, that'd be so nice. But that just doesn't ever happen. Do you want to know what the community's advice is on this? RNG manipulation. That's right. The only way that people put up with this bullshit is if they do their movements, like, perfectly, and then they line it up and, like, look at a spreadsheet and be like, oh, okay, raise, raise, cancel, cancel. It's so stupid. Like, the fact that they're like, you have to even do that is so dumb. This bullshit is RNG hell. Like, if you don't know that, you can literally waste all day doing this. Well, no, it's so stupid. It takes literally 12 hours of the game day. That is so much of your Digimon's life. A typical Digimon lives 15 days if it's a champion, 20 if it's an ultimate. That is a 30th or 40th of their goddamn life. That is just so much for something that you barely have control over. It's so dumb, too. Guess what happens when you complete all this? What does Monochromon do in the city? He becomes a shop Digimon. That's so fucking dumb. Panamon becomes one. Biomon becomes one. Unimon becomes one. It just becomes like another shop Digimon. That's so stupid. Why not like have this in the basement? Because like I think maybe if you're to do this for fun instead of like trying to unlock him, I feel like it actually could be fun at that point. But it's just like it's just so annoying trying to 100% this game and reaching this part every time. Because Digimon World 1 is again one of my favorite games of all time. But when I come to this part, it's like the only part that I sigh and say like this isn't fun. Straight up, this isn't fun. I love like going to Toy Town, getting Mazimon. I love like fighting Birdramon. I love fighting Machinedramon, going back up and getting Digitamamon. But this Monochromon bullshit, this is the single part that I'm like, fuck this. I straight up don't want to do this. Yeah, that's basically about it. I just really wanted to talk about that because, man, my review for Digimon World's coming soon. But playing through the game again, I got to this part, and I'm like, you know what? A mini rant on this would be kind of fun. So yeah, I'm just going to throw up a half hour of gameplay of this stupid shit. And I'm basically done speaking here, but hey, if you want to keep taking a look at it, have at it. Fuck this stupid-ass minigame. My least favorite minigame in all of gaming history.
Bye.